Hi friends, welcome to our channel Scrutiny Q. Today we will do scrutiny on be kind and think wisely. Let's see a story. Mr. James was getting ready to leave his office and he remembered that his wife had asked him to bring 1 kg of apples. When he stepped out, he saw an ill-looking old lady across the road. She was selling fresh apples on the street. Mr. James usually buys apple from a grocery shop few blocks away from his office, but since he was in hurry to reach home today, he thought about buying them from across the road only. He went to the old lady and asked her the price. She quoted $7 per 1 kg. He told, "But the store where I usually buy from gives them for $5 per 1 kg. Can you not give me for the same price?" The old lady told, "No sir, I cannot afford to match that price. I can sell them to you at $6 per 1 kg. That's best I can afford to give you for." Mr. James told her, "Never mind." He left in his car towards the usual grocery shop. He went inside and picked up a good bunch of apples. He went to the cashier to pay for them, but he was surprised when the cashier told him that price for 1 kg is $10. He told the cashier, "I have been buying apples from here only for some years and this is a steep price increase. Can't you offer me a better deal for being a loyal customer?" The manager overheard him and came there. He told Mr. James, "Sorry sir, but our prices are fixed. We do not bargain." Mr. James felt little bad with that flat attitude. He thought for a second and put those apples back. He went back to the old lady. She recognized him instantly and told him, "Sir, I can't match that price. I won't be able to earn any profit." Mr. James told her, "Don't worry about the price. I will pay you $10 per kg. Now give me 2 kg. The old lady got very happy. She packed 2 kgs of apples and said, "I can't take $10, but I will take $7 per kg. I appreciate your kindness." She also told him, "My husband used to own a small food shop, but he got very sick. We have no child or any relative who could support us. We had to sell his shop to cover his medical bills, but he could not survive." Tears were flowing from her eyes. She said, "But now to support myself, I am trying to sell what I can afford to buy and sell so I can survive for what's left of my life." Mr. James told her, "Don't worry, you are doing good and from tomorrow on, I will only buy apples from you." He pulled out his wallet and gave her $100 extra and said, "Take this, bring more different fruits to sell tomorrow. Consider this as an advance payment for fruits I will be buying from you. You can earn more if you have more choices of fruits to sell." The old lady hanged him. Later, he recommended many of his colleagues to buy fruits from the lady, which they did. And with the support of Mr. James and many other buyers, she made a better living. So friends, often we choose to go in big malls or big grocery shops for our shopping. We always pay the fixed price without bargaining. That is fine, as we all have choices and people who run their business have their liabilities too. However, we need to spare a moment and think why we have no courage or reason to bargain while shopping at big shops and why we try to bargain heavily with small street vendors. Think wisely. Always be helpful and supportive to someone who works hard to earn and has a need for it. Think what Mr. James had thought for a second and why he decided to buy from the old lady.